Zeno Education Society, redefining excellence.
Hello, myself Vaishali Kshatri from Zeno Polytechnic SYEG. So I am going to introduce about the project on sensor alarm system using thyristor. My group members are Pooja Kumbar, Dhanushi Dabade, Komal Jadhav, including me. Also, our guide who helped into work out for this project, Priti Gaikwad ma'am. Thank you for your guiding. So, let us begin with the project sensor alarm system using thyristor. Okay. I will explain the sensor alarm system using thyristor. So let us look on the page. As you can see, sensor alarm using thyristor, as the name indicates, does the job of sensing and indication using an alarm. The circuit uses diodes, capacitors, resistors for biasing the thyristor and sounding the alarm. This sensor alarm is designed to detect intrusion, unauthorized entry into a building or area. This sensor alarm can be used in residential, commercial, industrial, and military properties where the coverage area for alarm is very large for protection against burglary, and as a tool for personal protection against intruders. The basic idea was to make a sensor alarm which can withstand and operate on large power and serve a purpose of burglary protection and intrusion protection. So now you are watching project components, what they have. First, voltage supply, 9 voltage, switches, thyristor, LEDs, resistors, R1 is equal to 1K, R2 is equal to 2.2K, R3 is equal to 33K, R4 is equal to 10K, R6 is equal to 560, R7 is equal to 0.8K, capacitors, C1 is equal to 400, C2 is equal to 400, potentiometer 6 kilo ohm. So now you are watching the working of sensor alarm system using thyristor. As you can see the diagram, a thyristor is a 2-4 lead solid state semiconductor device with 4 layers of alternating N and P type material. They act exclusively as bistable switches conducting when their gate receive a current trigger and continue to conduct while they are forward biased. That is, while the voltage across the device is not received. A 3-lead thyristor is designed to control the larger current of its 2 leads by combining that current with the smaller current or voltage of its other lead, known as its control lead. On the other hand, a 2-lead thyristor is designed to switch on if the potential difference between its lead is sufficiently large, a value representing its breakdown voltage. The red lead shown in the above circuit diagram indicates the state of the input supply voltage. When red LED is on, indicates that supply voltage is on the vice versa. The resistor R2 and capacitor C1 forms the RC charging system, while resistor R5 is used to adjust the firing angle of SCR. The green LED is the actual output. It glows only when SCR gets triggered. Initially, suppose supply voltage is off, so both red and green LED are off. Now supply voltage is turned on, so simultaneously red LED glows but green LED is still off. Now if switch is press by user after adjusting R5, for certain value, immediately green LED glows as soon as voltage across capacitor equals triggering voltage of SCR. Due to this, SCR goes in forward conducting region and green LED glows. Now, when switches release capacitor, C2 discharges through R7, and after some time SCR gets turned off and green LED 2 turns off. Thus, the firing angle of SCR and in turn the time for which green LED glows can be controlled by user by adjusting value of resistor R5. So this is the how it is designed, and then let's see if it has any applications. So first is signaling for help through SOS. Second one is in communication between ships. Third one is during maritime operations. Fourth one is during situations regarding security and easy transmission of important messages. And then let's see their advantages. First is circuit is compact and simple to design. Second, thyristors can provide controlled rectification, that is provide DC from an AC source with a wide range of voltage or current control. Third, firing angle can be adjusted from 0 to 180 degrees with very less variation of resistor. And there is disadvantages. First, circuit is application specific, and for using same circuit for related applications, some modifications are needed. Second, thyristor latch in the one state once they begin to conduct and remain on after the gate pulse is removed until they are reverse biased. So result is the sensor alarm sends if there is any emergency, and LED is used for the its indication. A buzzer can also be used for indication. Let's see in future scope on sensor alarm system using thyristor. Thus, we have designed a sensor alarm using thyristor which can withstand large power and can be used for various security applications. A buzzer or an alarm system can be incorporated for better results. For multi-level emergencies, a firing circuit can be used with of help of which the firing angle of thyristor, that is the period of the indicator, can be varied. Thank you for watching this project.
Zeal Education Society, redefining excellence.